Bazaar Special Edition.
Good evening, you're watching the special edition of the News Hour and I'm Swati Joshi. Let's begin the broadcast with this breaking news coming in from West Bengal. And this is in connection to the violence that was witnessed in Sitalkuchi. That's also our debate number one. Now, hours after the fighting incident in Sitalkuchi in West Bengal, the Election Commission has blocked parties from campaigning in the area for the next 72 hours. Also, the poll body has announced that campaigning for the next phases will end in 72 hours ahead of the poll day instead of 48 hours. We in fact also have Shreyasi joining us in the broadcast. Earlier, remember, the Election Commission, after going through the special observers reports, gave a clean chit to the central forces, reaching a conclusion that they fired in self-defense, and now it has in a way blocked parties from campaigning in the area in the Sitalkuchi assembly for the next 72 hours. Shreyasi is with us for more. Shreyasi, clearly the Election Commission is taking all these precautionary measures because we already have seen the trailer of what can happen in the speeches made.
Absolutely, and five lives lost today, Swati. That's the first coming in this election season here in West Bengal. And it was completely in Kuch Bihar where Sitalkuchi was the flashpoint today. Of course, the Election Commission had sought a report from the special observers by 5 p.m. today regarding the incident of booth number 126 in Sitalkuchi where CISF personnel had to open fire. Now, what we understand from the Election Commission and the SP of Kuch Bihar, who on record said that the entire incident occurred because the CISF had open fired in self-defense, because they were harassed by at least 300 to 350 villagers with armed who were armed with utensils, and also attacked and tried snatching weapons from the CISF personnel and enter the booth and damage the EVM. So those were the allegations that were coming in. But the entire situation unfolded based on a rumor is what the official statement says. Now, keeping this incident in mind, even the Prime Minister raising the issue during his poll campaign here, now the Election Commission is taking steps. Also, additional forces for the remaining four phases have been asked.
Remember, Shreyasi, in fact, the Chief Minister of West Bengal today in her address said that she would be going to the area, she would be visiting the hospital. That's where the mortal remains have been kept. Now, will she also be stopped after this latest order that has come in from the Election Commission?
Well, of course, that area is extremely sensitive right now, and the polling has been adjourned by the Election Commission after violence unfolded in booth number 126. Now, we'll have to wait and see, because the Chief Minister has already on record announced that she will be in Sitalkuchi tomorrow. She will not only visit the deceased families and go to the hospital, but she will also be going to the spot where the incident took place, which, of course, is now being covered by the central forces. Additional forces are being moved to West Bengal for the remaining four phases. But of course, the Trinamool Congress, of course, is going to be latching on to this issue. They've called for a statewide protest tomorrow.
Stay on with us, because the TMC has responded to the Election Commission's latest order. Mahua Moitra of the TMC has tweeted, and I quote, CISF lacked professionalism of CRPF and local police, including armed constabulary, in dealing with mobs and restive crowds. Result for deaths. The Election Commission stopping leaders, not the answer. Stop trigger happy forces. So the TMC already has responded, and their conclusion is that the CISF lacks professionalism. Let me go back to Shreyasi for a quick response. TMC has started now slamming the Election Commission and the Central Forces as well.
Well, Central Forces have already been a hot topic here in the state of West Bengal. While on one hand, Chief Minister Mamata Banerjee had made a comment saying, gherao the CRPS if they do not allow you to vote. She has been making these statements at her rally. She was served a notice by the Election Commission. The Trinamool Congress has time and again raised questions about the behavior of the Central Forces. And with today's incident, the Trinamool Congress is only intensifying that charge against the central forces, where they have gone on to say that they are trigger happy.
But you know, these reactions are coming in despite the SP of Cooch Bihar saying that the forces had to open fire in self-defense. Still, TMC there, Mawa Moitra there, saying that the CISF lacks professionalism. Thank you very much, Resi, for joining us on the broadcast with those details. Before we open this up and go across to our guests, let's take a look at the report on the violence that unfolded and the massive political blame game thereafter.
Violence marring the fourth phase of polling in Bengal. Clashes between CISF personnel and an angry mob left at least four dead in Sitalkuchi.
We are at Pathantoli polling booth in Cooch Bihar district of West Bengal, where a violent incident took place this morning, where one 19-year-old boy died of bullet injuries while three others sustained injuries in this violent attack, which took place at around 7 a.m. this morning. We have been told that the incident took place just when the polling was to begin at this polling station at 7 a.m. That was the official time when the gates would be open for polling. And at that time only, the location is just barely 100 meters away from this place where the violent attack took place. People were coming out in large numbers to cast their votes when they were confronted by a group of miscreants who were armed with weapons, firearms, and also we have been told they were armed with crude bombs. So the voters, they say, have threatened, the miscreants threatened the voters, and they have asked not to come here and cast their votes, and after that they resorted to firing.
As per the Election Commission, the forces fired in self-defense. Even the local SP agrees with that.
CISF jo personnel the jo booth mein detail the wo jo pass mein jo unka QRT the to wo usko unko bulaya ki usko reinforcement karne ke liye pura jo party tha uske sath jo security personnel CISF ka tha ek sath milke uske sath bahut zyada scuffling mara mari chamela ye sab chal raha tha us time uska jab rifle chheenne ka koshish kiya aur booth mein ke andar mein ghusne ka koshish kiya tab ये घटना घटा और सीआईएसएफ फायरिंग चालू की.
But that didn't stop the political blame game.
Mamata Banerjee during last 7-8-10 days she is pursuing a different line of narratives. That is, she is asking her supporters to go against central force. Why target central force? That is one very dangerous trend we have found in Mamata Didi's narratives, change of narratives. That is against central force, against election commission.
So the Prime Minister is in effect condoning the firing by the Central Armed Police Forces on innocent voters standing in queue. We condemn the statement of the Prime Minister to bring in the name of Mamata Banerjee into it. While she is sitting in Calcutta, as Subrata said, is totally condemnable. The Prime Minister must take responsibility and Amit Shah must resign.
It was soon the turn of Chief Minister Mamata Banerjee and Prime Minister Modi to join the war of words.
Didi, samasya suraksha balo ki nahi hai. Samasya aapki hinsak rajniti ki hai. समस्या छप्पा वोट, ये छप्पा वोट रुकने पर आपकी बौखलाहट अब सामने आई है. समस्या आपकी भड़काऊ बयानबाजी की है. आप बंगाल के लोगों को डराने की, उनमें भय फैलाने की जितनी कोशिश कर रही है, उतने ही ज्यादा लोग आपको हराने के लिए एकजुट हो रहे हैं.
टारगेट इज ओनली बिंगो बिकॉज आई एम फाइटिंग द बैटल. आई एम द ओनली वुमेन सीएम. आई एम फाइटिंग द बैटल. आई एम डूइंग द स्ट्रगल एंड आई एम फ्रॉम द स्ट्रगल. He knows that only I can give him the beating reply. That's why we want peaceful election. Every time I am appealing the people for peaceful election. Why they are not allowing? Who fired? Who killed our people? Within this election time, more than 18 people have been killed. Under this election commission time. 18, more than. Even out of that, maybe 13 from our party. Even if panchayat election, you people have raised so many issues. But panchayat election also never happened this. And whatever the incident happened, all election commission appointed the people. It is not that our state government appointed the people and incident happened. All the officers are being appointed by election commission and recommended by BJP.
While the face-off continues, any loss of life surely dampens the festival of democracy. Many in BJP today point to Mamata's Ghirao CRPF call, claiming that it was the trigger that incited people. TMC, on the other hand, claims the forces are working on the instructions of Home Minister Shah. Will the politics make way for peaceful conduct of polls? Bureau Report, Times Now.
You're watching the News Hour Special Edition, Debate Number 1, on Times Now, Super Prime Time.
Well, it's unfortunate that people have lost their lives, but this definitely has sparked a massive political face-off between the TMC and the BJP. Let's open this up and go across to our guests. We're joined by Sanju Verma, BJP spokesperson, Kailash Adhikari, Managing Director, Governance Now, Shahzad Poonawalla, Times Now's contributor, Riju Datta, TMC spokesperson, and Anirban Banerjee, lawyer and political analyst. Good evening to all of you. I first want to, of course, go across to Mr. Riju Datta. Riju Datta, we all know what TMC thinks of the Election Commission and the various statements that have been given as far as the Election Commission is concerned. But do you not trust the SP of Cooch Behar, who has narrated the entire incident and concluded that the security personnel were ghiraud by a mob? They were trying to snatch their weapons, and that's when they had to fire in self-defense.
Swati, let me call it what it is. It is a murder. It is a murder in the broad daylight of five youth, one of them a first-time voter, under the instructions of the Union Home Minister of this country. And that is why we collectively as a party demand his resignation. So let's call it what it is. And you know, when you talk about this, you know, this technicality about the SP of Cooch Behar, let me also remind you and the viewers that all the top echelons of the police administration was transferred by the EC on the recommendation of BJP. The new SP of Cooch Behar was posted there barely a few days ago. He does not even know the region. Now let me get into even deeper technicalities. Only as per the Ministry of Home Affairs, only CRPF jawans are trained in crowd control. Then please explain to me who is responsible for appointing CISF in the QRT of a sensitive booth in West Bengal. Who has done this cardinal mistake? And he has to be blamed, and he has to be resigned, and he has to be, you know, put behind bars, because that has caused the life of five youths. We have seen red terror in Bengal for 34 years.
So you're saying that the BJP is directing the central forces to fire on the voters. You're calling it a murder. The Bharatiya Janata Party ordering the central forces to target those very voters whose votes they are seeking. Okay, I'll go across to Sanju Verma. Sanju Verma, Riju Datta is saying, why was CISF deployed?
Can I
respond to that?
Okay.
Swati, you know, I have often used this quote, and I think it's apt to be used today itself. The only thing worse than a liar is a liar who is also a hypocrite. And I'm not surprised at the Trinamool spokesperson's hypocrisy, because we all are well aware of the fact that in the last 1 week alone, Mamata Banerjee, be it on the 7th of April, when at Baneshwar in Cooch Behar, she openly asked for Muslims to consolidate and vote en bloc to stop the Modi juggernaut, or beat her television interview to another channel on the 28th of March this year, where she openly said that if Muslims don't unite and vote en masse, we cannot stop Narendra Modi's BJP from taking charge in Bengal. So the fact that communal polarization has been the hallmark of Mamata Banerjee's politics ever since the polling began in Bengal, I think that is there out in the public domain. I want to ask Riju Datta, why is it that beat Derek O'Brien, beat Shougata Roy, beat Mamata Banerjee. Just look at their distasteful tweets. One says CRPF, BSF have blood on their hands. Mahua Maitra, a motor mouth and a loud mouth, says that CRPF has been openly molesting young women voters in Bengal. Shougata Roy says CRPF is a bunch of terrorists. Mamata Banerjee 2 days back tweeted, CRPF is a bunch of hooligans. If this is the kind of language you use for our central armed forces, and then you claim that you are the beacon of all that is good in Indian politics, you uphold the constitution, machinery.
Riju Datta, but then all these statements were made. Today, the Chief Minister of West Bengal has said, I have nothing against the Central Forces, but the Central Forces are being directed by the Home Minister. They are being directed by the center.
Absolutely. And, you know, I will give now very pertinent points. And Sanju started with a quote, so I will give you a quote for Sanju and the BJP people who are somehow supporting this act of violence and this act of murder, that it is by Mark Twain. It is better to keep your mouth closed and let people think you are a fool than open it and remove all doubt. See, the bottom line is, during the first phase, we have filed 6 complaints to the EC about CRPF coercing and manipulating our voters. Second phase, 18 complaints. Third phase, 134 complaints. Saraswati, EC has become a silent spectator.
If you are going to cite the complaints that have been registered, There will be a response from the Bharatiya Janata Party about the number of complaints that they have filed at the Election Commission. Lockett Chatterjee was attacked. Another BJP candidate, Payal, was attacked today. There are visuals of their cars being vandalized. So if you are going into the issue of complaints that were filed, I think both parties have filed enough complaints. I want to shift focus back to what happened in Cooch Behar. I want to bring in Shehzad Poonawala as well. Relax. Take a breath. Both Riju Datta and Sanju Verma. I'll come back to you. There are other panelists also. I'll come back to you and give you an equal opportunity to respond. I'll come back to you.
Please. Lockett Chatterjee broke her own glass pane.
That's what you are concluding. The BJP is saying that she was attacked. I am just presenting both versions. I am not saying that she was attacked by TMC. Neither am I saying that this was staged. This is what the TMC and the BJP have been saying. I want to go across to Shehzad Poonawala right now. Shehzad Poonawala, many are also saying that the Gherao call that was given has led to the violence that was witnessed on ground.
Swati, these are things that are borne out by pure hard facts. This was the fourth phase of polling. As you can understand that in the last 3 phases, there was negligible or no violence, something that we should have been very proud of. But today, as a very detrimental chat comes out on Clubhouse of the election strategist of Mamata Banerjee, somehow to deflect attention from there and also to ensure that polling process is affected in one way or the other, because there is a frustration of her, not just in Bengal, but also in Nandigram. So now there is a pattern ki ab EC ke baad central forces ko karo badnaam. And we see that directly in the same area where Mamata Banerjee first made the appeal that there should be a gherawing of the central forces, in the same area you see violence taking place. And it is not just borne out by the facts given out by the Election Commission, but by the West Bengal Police, the SP of Cooch Behar, who is also another participant in this entire process, has also independently verified that it was an attack done by these 350 people. They came with handmade weapons. There were women as per the call of Mamata Banerjee. And finally, it was in self-defense that this force has done it. But look what is happening. Even now, Mahua Moitra is blaming the central forces. These are the same forces that work not for a political party. They don't work for Dal, but they work for Desh. They put country above party. But here, time and again, there is an insult of the forces that is being done. And ironically, this is the party that takes Chhatradar Mahato into its fold, that takes Naxalites into its fold, that cries for Bhatla House encounter, and they doubt surgical strikes, they doubt Pulwama, they doubt Balakot, and today they are again raising these kinds of questions on our forces and on our
central forces. Anybody who's siding with the forces, the central forces are being called BJP's agents. I want to go across to Anirban Banerjee. The question is very simple. Why are the forces being dragged into it? If Mamata Banerjee herself says that she has nothing against the forces, the central forces, and that she is only making these charges because she believes they are being directed by the BJP. Why are you dragging the forces into it at all?
Well, yeah. Lest we forget, a few weeks back, the BJP leader, Mr. Sayantan Basu, in an open public meeting had said that he is going to ask the central forces to fire at the chest and not the legs. This is a statement recorded on camera. It was Mr. Sayantan Basu. I'll reiterate, in an open public meeting, he said that he'll call for the CRPF forces to fire at the chest and not the legs. And that is precisely what has taken place today. Therefore, who is dragging the central forces into this mire? It is the BJP at the behest of Mr. Amit Shah that the CRPF has done something as grievous as this. Therefore, it is not Mamata Banerjee, it is not the Trinamool, or it is not any other party. It is the BJP. Please play those records.
Okay.
It is on camera. It is on camera. It is on camera from an open public meeting. Mr. Sayantan Basu called for the CRPF.
You have a BJP spokesperson. Take a response. If Sanju Verma, you are alleging that it is because of the Gherao call given by Mamata Banerjee that you saw violence on ground, what about the provocation of your netas? Anirban Banerjee is asking that question. Please respond.
You know, Swati, I really love this false equivalence by this urban Naxalite political party called the Trinamool Congress. You know, they want to show that the statements made by Mamata Banerjee were made in
why
the right context.
Why do you come on a show if you are so ignorant, Madam Verma?
You know, no name calling, no name calling, because then this will completely be no name calling. Let's just
no name calling. She started it.
No name calling, please. Let's just answer the question. I am asking her to respond to the question. I am still there.
CRPF is
Anirban Banerjee. Are you listening to me? I said no name calling.
Talk about the BJP. Do you remember Diamond?
I said no name calling, Anirban Banerjee. I'm still here.
Do you remember 48 hours back when Dilip Ghosh's convoy was attacked? Do you remember today the brutal manner in which Lokesh Chatterjee was attacked? Do you remember the manner in which Bakul Supriyo and Rupa Ganguly have been consistently attacked verbally and physically? So please stop being the judge, the jury and the executioner. And stop trying to take the moral high ground.
That is why you murdered these four
Trilochan
people.
Mahato,
are you trying
Kumar,
to justify
Ganesh
this murder?
Roy, Devendranath Roy.
Are you trying
these
to justify this murder? Are you saying that this is a reaction?
From trees.
So
and
did you use the CRPF to murder
workers.
These four people?
Today, an
so did you use the CRPF
okay, now let me bring in Kailash Adhikari as well.
Killed was also
let me bring in Kailash Adhikari now. Kailash Adhikari. Kailash Adhikari. You've been listening to everyone. I'm sure you've also heard the versions that are coming in as far as the Election Commission and the SP of Cooch Bihar is concerned. What according to you is really happening in West Bengal? Who's responsible for the violence? Who's jittery? Who's scared? Who's doing this out of fear? Who is, committing these crimes?
You know, Swati, sir, first of all, I'd like to mention that, you know, what happened was a very sad incident and our condolences to the bereaved family. Now, having said that, you know, Bengal elections have always been characterized by such kind of violences. Now, it is also very shameful to see, Swati, the way both the political parties are trying to score sympathetic brownie political points over the murder of the five people, the incident that happened, and they call it a murder. Whereas even the Election Commission has given a clean chit that it was an act in self-defense. And I totally condemn the tweet by Ms. Mahua Mitra
you know, undermining the importance and the importance of our central armed forces. As citizens of this nation, I believe, Swati, that the CISF and the other central armed forces are highly disciplined and we must repose our trust in them. Now, having said that, both the parties coming to the front and saying that the 18-year-old Anand Burman died, TMC saying that he was TMC-eyed, BJP saying that he was BJP-eyed, I think we should rise above such kind of politics. And Prime Minister has also urged the Election Commission that a complete thorough investigation of the matter should be done. And I believe that as subject matters of this nation, we must believe in the investigation and the results that come out.
Okay, I want to take a response from Rijudhata. Rijudhata, of course, we know what the TMC stand is. Who do you think, provoked the people who came in such large numbers and harassed the central forces? Do you believe there was some sort of a provocation behind what happened?
I'll tell you something very, very straightforward. You know, this is a part of a much larger conspiracy to spoil the voting system of Bengal. After four phases, BJP are in their internal report have understood that they have lost the plan. Have you seen the dip in the final polling percentage today from the first three phases? More than 4%. Why? Because this is what they want to instill in the voters of Bengal, that aap yahan par vote dene aaoge, agar TMC kahoge to hum aapko goli maar denge. Aur har goli ka jawab ab Bengal ki janta ballot mein jaake degi. You know, you can do that. If we are anti-BJP, we are terrorists. If we are anti-BJP, we go to vote, you will shoot us. Then shoot us. You already have blood in your hands. And I'm sure it is nothing new for you people.
Go ahead, do it. How will you know that you will get the ballots? Those who are voting are coming, Rijudhata. How do you know that they are in the polling booth that these people are anti-BJP? And if people will throw bullets at BJP and will scare voters, then how will they win?
नहीं तो मैं आपसे ये पूछ रहा हूँ ना कि अगर उनको 300 350 लोग ने घेराव किया था सीआरपीएफ को तो चार लोगों को जो गोली लगा वो टीएमसी के ही समर्थक थे उस घेराव में कोई बीजेपी नहीं था एंड एवरी पोल बूथ इज सराउंडेड बाय सीसीटीवी फुटेज व्हाई दिस
आप कह रहे हैं कि 300-400 की भीड़ में से आइडेंटिफाई किया गया कि ये चार लोग टीएमसी के हैं इन्हीं को गोली मारते हैं आप कह रहे हैं कि इतनी भीड़ में फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल यू डू अग्री कि 300-400 लोगों ने घेराव किया यू जस्ट गोइंग बाय द एसपी वर्जन You just go.
There was no bhiri.
I am going by what the SP has said. It is on record.
There was no.
It is on record.
It was a story.
What the SP of Kuch Bihar is saying is on record or not?
No.
The SP of Kuch Bihar, what he said is on record or not? So Shehzad Poonawala, tell me something. If 300-400 की भीड़ थी वहाँ पर, तो CISF के पास 300-400 की भीड़ में they were in the middle, they were घेराव. 300-400 लोगों में से they identified कि ये चार TMC के हैं, इन्हीं को गोली मारते हैं.
You see, that sounds very unplausible, and I hope my dear friends Anirban and Riju, I have not interrupted you. So give me 30 seconds, then you come in, and even Sanjuji wants to speak. Just 30 seconds. See, I was not on the spot, nor was my dear friend Riju, nor was Anirban, nor was Kailashji, nor was Sanju. Only person who was at the spot was the officials on the ground, the police party, the CISF, the quick response team. They have compiled a report. We have a system in this country. Technically, political violence has taken place in Bengal for a very long time, and every time it takes place, it benefits the ruling establishment. It benefited the left parties. That time, Mamata Banerjee used to complain, and she used to demand central forces and election commission's intervention. Today, it benefits TMC because they are in power. In 2018, we have seen what has happened. And any party which is in power technically benefits more from political violence and the subsequent reduction in voting. So my dear friends Riju and Anirban have to explain that at a time when your strategist has spilled the beans out of the bag and realizing that maybe all are going to face defeat, was it orchestrated, planned, and even Mamata Didi
that's another debate.
Party workers.
That's entirely a different debate, Shehzad Poonawala. But Anirban Banerjee...
give you a categorical answer, but I will tell you this.
Okay, now what I can do is I can give all of you 20 seconds before I wrap up. What I can do is I can give you 20 seconds before I wrap up. Let's begin with Riju Dutta and then Sanju Verma.
Yes,
Sanjuji, please, thoda sa wait kijiye. 20 seconds. I am coming to you. 20 seconds to Riju and then 20 seconds to you.
I will only say the election. Yes, Swati, thank you. Yes, I will only say the election commission started doing 8-phase elections in Bengal citing violence. So if the election commission and the entire CRPF or the the plethora of forces cannot maintain violence, then why this drama of 8 phases? They have failed miserably, and the central forces have killed 5 youths of Bengal under the instructions of Amit Shah, and he should resign immediately. He is responsible for the death of 5 youths, and he is a murderer who has got blood in his hands.
Okay, Riju, I hope you're satisfied. I gave you 20 seconds without interruption. Let Sanju respond. Let Sanju respond. I interfered. I am interfering. I am allowing you to speak. Go ahead, Sanju Verma. Take your time. 20 seconds.
You know, Swati, I think Shehzad made a very pertinent point, and I just want to say that while the election commission has said that a probe report is awaited, there is a preliminary report by the Border Security Force which clearly says that a murderous mob not only tried to snatch the rifles and weapons of the CISF officials, but one inspector called Sunil Kumar was also injured. So let me tell the Trinamool spokesperson here, who's been mouthing platitudes about how Mamata Banerjee will win, the fact of the matter is that Mamata Banerjee has been trying to delegitimize the election commission ever since the press conference announcing the polling dates in West Bengal happened. And let me tell you one more thing. Who are you? Didi or Didi? Aap Amit Shah ki resignation mat mangiye. You were also the Home Affairs Minister of West Bengal, apart from being the Chief Minister. Have you bothered to resign from your post as Home Minister in the last 10 years? The maximum amounts of political killings, communal violence, the maximum amount of violence against women.
I want to go across to Anirban now.
Something in which West Bengal scores.
All right, Anirban Banerjee. Now, Anirban Banerjee, who will you trust?
Why does she keep
election
saying,
election machinery ko aap trust nahi karte, central forces ko bhi aap trust nahi karte. तो आप पश्चिम बंगाल में अभी जो चुनाव हो रहे हैं इसको लेकर किसको ट्रस्ट करेंगे? अनिर्बान बैनर्जी प्लीज कम इन. संजू प्लीज, लेट्स बी फेयर टू अदर्स. संजू प्लीज, आई वांट टू गो अक्रॉस टू अनिर्बान बैनर्जी नाउ.
वी
अनिर्बान बैनर्जी, गो अहेड.
वी कंप्लीटली ट्रस्ट द पीपल. वी कंप्लीटली ट्रस्ट द पीपल. वी यूज टू ट्रस्ट द इलेक्शन कमीशन एज वेल बिफोर इट चोज टू सरेंडर बिफोर अमित शाह. And it is very clear from the so-called chronology. Aap chronology ko samjhiye. It is the BJP leaders who from public meetings say that they will ask the central forces to fire at the chest and not the legs, which is the protocol if attacked. At the pretext of self-defense, you cannot murder civilians. Miss Sanju Verma, Miss Sanju Verma, my good friend Shehzad, was trying to make this case.
Pehle aapka delegation election commission se milta hai. Kehta hai ki humko deployment ko lekar kuch sawal hai. Phir kehta hai election commission ne humko pura assurance diya. Then you doubt the integrity of the election commission. Then you go file complaints with the election commission. Chronology dusri taraf ki bhi thoda dekhni padegi. Shehzad, 20 seconds to you. I have to wrap up.
One line, just one line. My dear friend Anirban, should not have conditional commitment in EC and in central forces. Jab chunav jeeto tab bharosa, jab chunav na jeeto to unko gali dena. Isse manobal par asar padta hai.
Shehzad, 4 Bengalis were murdered, bhai. Four Bengalis were murdered. At least have some sorrow. Four Bengalis were murdered. Election commission, CIS.
You know, Anirban, for the first time in the debate, I think you're the only one who's saying, for the first time in this entire debate, you're the only one who has said 4 Bengalis have died. I really appreciate what you've said. At least उनको डिवाइड नहीं किया जा रहा है कि बीजेपी वाले थे कि टीएमसी वाले थे कि इस रिलीजन के थे कि उस रिलीजन के थे. आई रियली अप्रिशिएट यू सेइंग 4 बेंगालीज हैव डाइड. बिफोर आई रैप अप, कैलाश अधिकारी, लास्ट वर्ड टू यू.
यू नो स्वाति, थैंक यू सो मच फॉर दैट. आई बिलीव दैट एज नेशंस ऑफ द सिटीजंस, वी मस्ट नॉट बीट द बीजेपी और द टीएमसी. वी मस्ट नॉट अंडरमाइन the importance and the work carried out by the Election Commission on the Central Armed Forces. They are doing it for the nation, the Election Commission as well. It is a body which is carrying out, which has the responsibility of carrying out the elections of the largest democracy in the world. And no political party or no individual without any substantive proof should raise fingers on the Election Commission or the Central Armed Forces. Thank you.
All right. Thank you very much. And with that, I'm wrapping up debate number one. A quick break. Coming up on the other side is debate number two. Also, a poll controversy from West Bengal.